distinguishing between what we mean by descriptive statistics and inferential statistics. These are the two branches of statistics that we have. Let's look at descriptive statistics first. Descriptive statistics describe what's present in the data set, or it might indicate the relationship between two data sets. These are the types of things that we are concerned with in descriptive statistics. Within the word descriptive, you can see the word describe. That's why we call them descriptive statistics, because as we said, they describe data set. They describe what's present in the data set. For example, we might have a set of test scores. Let's say we have four test scores, 75 on the first test, 75 on the second test, 85 on the third test, and 85 on the fourth test. Now, a descriptive statistic will describe this data set, will describe these numbers. We can come up with one descriptive statistic to describe this set of numbers. And usually that descriptive statistic is an average of what we call a mean. We get the average or the mean of these test scores. The average of these test scores, or the mean of these test scores, equals 80. This is an example of a descriptive statistic. This one number describes this data set. It is a descriptive statistic. We can also use descriptive statistics to indicate the relationship between various sets. Statistic can indicate that there's a relationship between two variables. For example, we might talk about cigarette smoking and cancer. There's a relationship between those variables. So there's a statistic that we can use to describe that relationship. And this would be called a descriptive statistic. If we wanted to describe the relationship between a political party and the relationship between whether or not a person votes, there's a statistic that we can use to describe that relationship. So this is what we mean by descriptive statistics, and this is just one branch of statistics. Now, let's talk about the other branch of statistics. The other branch of statistics is what we call inferential statistics. Inferential statistics. Inferential statistics. In inferential statistics, we're trying to make some type of inference, or we're trying to make some type of prediction. That's generally what we're trying to do in inferential statistics. So for inferential statistics are used to make inferences. You can infer things based on these type of statistics. These type of statistics are used to infer things about maybe a population based on a sample. Or you might have a situation wherein you're trying to predict what will happen 2,000 years from now, are 2 million years from now. So not only do we make inferences in inferential statistics, but we also sometimes make predictions. We make predictions. And this is a very important part of inferential statistics, being able to make a prediction. Using inferential statistics, we can predict when a bank will have problems. Using inferential statistics, we can predict when a business will fail or some type of going concern. We can predict when that business will fail using inferential statistics. So inferential statistics are a very powerful type of statistics because we're not just describing what we see, but we are making inferences. We are making predictions in inferential statistics. So this is the other branch of statistics. And as we said, these are the two types of statistics that